Egg freezing is pretty much what it says. We're able to collect eggs and freeze them for use at a future date. In order to freeze a woman's eggs, she needs to go through what we call a stimulated cycle, where she's given medication to encourage the ovaries to produce more than one egg, which is the normal biological job in each menstrual cycle. And from there, we're able to collect multiple eggs that we can then freeze in the lab for use at a later date. There's several groups of women who should think about egg freezing. First of all, there might be women with medical conditions such as a cancer about to undergo chemotherapy or radiotherapy, which may actually damage the woman's eggs. So it's important that women in this situation talk to a fertility specialist about options. Sometimes the ideal time for a woman biologically to have a child doesn't necessarily agree with the time in her life when she's actually ready. So egg freezing gives us an opportunity to freeze some eggs and have them available for later use, perhaps when that woman's own biological decline of her own fertility is starting to kick in. City Fertility Centre follows national guidelines with regards to egg freezing, and current guidelines suggest that eggs are able to be frozen for up to 10 years. It's really important that the results of egg freezing and chances of pregnancy are individualised for an individual woman based on her age, her ovarian reserve, or broadly speaking, how many eggs she's got left. And once we've got that information, as well as looking at her complete medical history, we can individualise her chances of success. Generally speaking, though, we'd expect a single pregnancy if a woman had around 10 to 15 eggs frozen. Once a woman decides that it's time to utilise her frozen eggs, it's a matter of the scientists thawing those out. They're then fertilised with sperm to create embryos. The embryos are cultured for several days in the laboratory, and they're transferred back into the woman's uterus, where the embryo will implant, grow, and hopefully develop onto a successful pregnancy. Knowledge is power, so I think it's really important that women know what's available and what's out there for them. Making an appointment with a fertility specialist is really important, and who's going to be able to go through those statistics and information with your exact circumstance, because you can't always trust everything you read on the internet.